2.
So this is Mojo, and they have a couple oars here on the back. Oh, I see now the where they sit down low. So that's kind of nice. They're down low and not up high.
So this one here has got a setup with the bicycle under the seat, pedal drive, straight shaft coming all the way out, and then a two-plate prop.
So is your dog one of your crew?
No, he would hate it, so he's not coming with us or with me. He's gonna stay here.
He looks pretty tired, pretty wiped out as it is.
Yeah, that's about as useful as he gets.
And in your pedal drive, it looks like there's a little trim tab on the prop shaft.
It's well, not so much. It actually holds the bearing together, like where that the shaft goes through, but it also acts as a warning when I'm going over a piece of kelp or wood or whatever, so I can hear it hit this before it hits the prop.
Ah.
I get a chance to pull the prop up.
Oh,
so
okay.
It's helped me a few times not get weeds wrapped around the prop, because they get caught in there first, and I get a chance to stop them from fouling the actual prop.
That's clever.
It's been helpful.
Oh man, I can imagine what a hassle it would be to clean out the prop.
It lifts up, so I can get to it, but it gets pretty high up, so it's a little bit awkward to get to.
Right, yeah.
And being by myself, I don't want to hang over the side too much.
Yeah,
if I can avoid it.
Right.
Don't want to fall in. Yes.
Yeah, you're going solo. Yeah. Well, all right.
With no dogs.
Yeah. Oh, he's...
Madam Oracle and the Prairie Porch Pirates, yes.
So do you guys just sit out on your porch and dream of doing this? Or?
No, we spent a lot of time fixing boats.
Yeah.
As a matter of fact.
Yeah. So. How was your crossing on Monday?
Good.
Yeah?
Not bad at all. We actually had a pretty good... Yep, there we go. We're good. Yeah. No, it went well, actually.
Yeah.
All things considered, it went okay.
Well, this one here, they got the pedal drive cushion there to sit on and pedal away, but Trimaran's probably pretty fast and light, so hopefully they don't have to use that too much. Quite the drive there.
So our drive, we've used it last 360. We used it last year. We like it. It's all centered around efficiencies. It's our belief that most of these boats, the speed, everybody talks about how fast you're going to go.
Yeah.
And it's our belief that most of the speeds are baked into the hull shape of the boat itself, not really the pedal drive.
Sure.
So our goal is just to get all the watts that we're using down into the water.
Yeah.
So we're driving the drive shaft straight with their chain, and it's driving the prop. There's no more energy transfer.
Right.
And then we put the duct on for an added efficiency. Put a weed shedding prop on there just because we don't want to haul the thing out of the water. The kelp's a huge
big deal.
And we've tested this, and actually we're thrilled that this morning, we had a huge glob of kelp right in front of it.
Yeah.
And we sucked it in, and I guess it must be somebody else's problem.
Back there, yeah.
So it went right through, and no problems whatsoever.
Yeah.
So. It's easy. You want to get on the truck?
Yeah.
Come on.
Love you.
I mean, it's all about making it easy. We want to achieve that speed as easy as possible.
So I'm gonna counter with my weight here that
that's fine.
We'll end up going backwards.
No. You ready?
Yeah, here we go.
So if you watch, you're probably
we're coming up on the lines. Wow, the line went tight. Yeah, that's
absolutely.
Quick.
Yeah, and we'll start sucking some air down there after a little bit. And
so is it? It looks like the I call it the nozzle. The nozzle.
That's good.
Yeah. It looked like it dropped down a little bit more with. Is that just because my weight on here?
No.
Or is it?
No. So it's
more
pushing against us right now.
Yeah.
And as it does that, it tends to drop. If we were moving forward, that whole duct and assembly would actually just trail right below the surface. It has this streamline effect, and it'll actually stay 2 to 3 inches even through the waves.
We'll
be bobbing up and down.
Yeah.
And that duct will stay right where it's supposed to be.
Yeah.
So it works out really well.
So like this pace here, I'm assuming you're pedaling too. Okay, yeah.
Yeah.
trick the dock walker. Yeah, come on out of here and pedal.
Sure.
<just me.
laughs> Sure. No.
So is this about the pace that you would go if you're
60-70 RPM, something like that.
In there. Okay. Yeah.
But so I'll stop pedaling.
Yeah. Okay.
And you can start to feel how jerky it becomes.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's a totally different thing.
You looked a lot smoother when you were pedaling.
So,
are you clipped in?
No, I'm not.
Okay.
We do have clips.
Okay, yeah.
But yeah, so the goal is by putting two people, we put the pedals 90 degrees out of phase.
Ah,
and it allows me to be pushing down while you're coming up.
Oh, okay.
Just keep a very smooth.
Yeah, it's a totally different experience with both of us. Yeah,
so it's teamwork.
Yeah.
It's all figured in. But you'll see that in some of the videos, the singles, depending on the size of the prop and stuff.
Right.
Yeah, they have
right.
This is our way around it.
Two-blade prop?
Two-blade prop.
Okay.
We made the prop. It's got like a 23-inch pitch.
Yeah.
A little bit more aggressive than some.
Yeah. Well, okay, I'm going to call my experience good here.
All right, good deal.
Howdy. Looking at your pedal drive set up here.
Yeah.
You want to go? I was like, where's the prop? But it's straight down. Yeah.
It's the same as their system there. See it? That's
Yeah. All right. Oh, yeah. Huh.
You're going to sit and try.
Yeah.
All right. Let's give it a whirl. All right. Well, we got a good spring line here.
Don't hit the boat in front.
Yeah. I'm headed for Japan. Yeah.
Don't hit the guy in front of you.
Actually, how is it sprung? I guess there's a...
And it's got a reverse gear as well.
Yeah. let's see. Two-bladed prop?
Yeah, same as that.
Same as that, okay. Well, it's going to be optimistic if I'm going to get out of here without getting wet. So.
You can step on trampoline.
I'll go there.
Yeah, you can get up this one. Yeah.
There we go. I'm up. So they are set up with a three-bladed prop, and I believe what they have are two pedal drives, or two people pedaling, but it's driving one prop. Yeah, so these guys here, they have a five-bladed prop, and we got some gears. So, like the offshore racing boat, they have propellers that just, they call them surface piercing. So this prop doesn't go all the way in the water. It's just the lower half of the blades pushing. It's kind of interesting, these stretcher boards, they actually look like the official mountain rescue where you gotta haul someone out of the woods backboards. And they have two props, and they got pedal drives up there.
We turn these things and hope it propels the boat.
Yeah, right. Yeah.
So we've got a sea cycle that goes through a motor well in the bottom of our boat.
Oh, okay.
The boat's Hobie 33s have a motor well you can drop an outboard into.
Right.
We dropped a kayaking sea cycle down in there. And took the pedals off and put two sprockets on it.
It is what it is. We just want to get
at least two chains.
For us, it's about
the sprockets.
Yeah.
It's been with the pedals and.
You doing anything tricky like 90-degree offset?
So inside the sea cycle, inside the sea cycle, he's got a big sprocket.
Yeah.
And then the chain goes down and twists to another sprocket on the bottom, and then that turns the sprocket.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. But like Race for Alaska, you gotta do a little boat work before you.
A lot of boat work. A lot of field.